Good morning, everybody. Good morning, TikTok. Sisters, lost, saved, Holy Ghost of God, come in. I feel the power and presence of God. Thank you, Lord, for this special occasion, special anointing. Thank you, Lord, for revival and world revival, true revival, not pretend, not put on. The outpouring of the Holy Ghost, the evidence of power, gifts, your blessings, your favor, your presence, your atmosphere. The world neglects you, but we welcome you, Holy Ghost. It transforms by the renewing of your minds. Put on the mind of Christ. Put ye on the Lord Jesus. Good morning, everybody. Good morning. There are some sick. There's some out. We bind it in the name of Jesus. We loose it. We plead the blood. We rebuke it in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord's strength, the Lord's grace, the Lord's mercy. Praise God. The Lord's favor, the Lord's blessing, the Lord's honor, the Lord's anointing. Praise the Lord. This is not just an internet pastoral. This is a real ordained pastoral and church from heaven. I'm not just an internet pastor. I serve the one true master. Praise God. Welcome everybody. This is my church. I will not receive another spirit or another Jesus or any other message save Jesus Christ and Him crucified. Devil, this is our church. You can't have it. Back up and get out in Jesus' name. We plead the blood and we belong to Jesus. Amen. We still got about five more minutes. Intercession and prayer, preparation. We just thank God for another day to serve Him and praise Him and worship Him. We thank both. We thank Him for the opportunity, the anointing, the ordination. We thank Him for the calling. We thank Him for salvation. We thank Him for truth and sound doctrine. We thank Him for a good family. We thank Him for the family of God. We thank Him for the redeemed. We thank Him for the gifts and callings of God are without repentance. We thank you, Father, that Your soon coming King, King of kings and Lord of lords, the Lord Jesus, He's ever with us, ever so whither we go. And wherever He is, that is where I want to be also, in His presence, His power, and His anointing. The sound of His voice is a still small voice. Or if it's the voice that breaketh the cedars, I thank Him. I praise Him. I love Him. We worship Him today. Real quick before we get started, ways to donate. To give, the text number is 844-558-1366. If you enjoy this church and the calling and anointing, if you enjoyed the revival and didn't get a chance to give into the revival, you can have another chance at it. And secure my Vanco home, Mount Moriah. Cash App, Pastor Gene 777. The storehouse 777 at PayPal. So many people say, I don't like the text. I don't know what Vanco is. I can't use Cash App. I don't trust PayPal to take donations where you can mail in a letter, you can mail in a money order or check, or if you prefer cash, to Mount Moriah Church. 228 Mount Moriah Church Road, Hamlet, North Carolina, 28345. You will be blessed beyond measure sowing into this church, this ministry. This is not my ministry. This is God's ministry. This is not my church. This is God's house. And you can also give live if you give here, if you come to the church. We thank you for the love and support and donations. God bless you all continually. In Jesus' name, thank you in advance. Always remember, revival begins with you and revival never stops. Acts chapter 2 never stops. Praise the Lord. As we prepare to open, we've got about 1 minute. Operator, come and pause this. We're going to ask Miss Diane to open us as we have asked the Holy Ghost of God into our presence in the building. And she's going to make a couple of selections, maybe two selections of the Lord leading her. Thank you. Welcome. Good morning.
120 in the church hymnal.
Thank you.
Amen. Praise God. Thank you for that wonderful music. And we also want to thank you for what you did, and the Lord knows all about it. It means a lot to God. We ask the Lord a mighty blessing in Jesus' name. Thank you for that note. It's humbling, and we just thank God. Bless you so much. Praise God. You're such an asset out here, and been many a time, it's just been us. Seems like that today, but it's not. We got angels. We got the Holy Ghost. Amen. God is so good. He's so wonderful. At this point, it's like nothing can stop us. It's nobody's going to stop us. Nothing. Greater is He that is within us than He that is within the world. And people can live like the world if they want to, but it's not what God asks us to do. And the Bible says, therefore, now there is no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. It is a fact. However, the Bible also says that if the word condemns us, then the word is greater than our hearts. That means we've got to get our hearts right. So your heart, you can condemn yourself by not following scripture. You got to be in context. You've got to have sound doctrine. You got to rightly divide, and you got to be led of the Spirit, not of the spirit of this world, not of self-will, but of the Holy Ghost. He's a holy God. Amen. Hallelujah. Real quick, we're going to get into Revelation 5:9, and then we'll get into the teaching. And we thank God as the operator's getting ready to come up here. Remember, she's 8 years old. That's important to know because she does it better than me. And I'm 4 times. The point is, almost 5 times. I better not keep going. I'll be the overshot one. 5 times, 6 times. The world champion, huh? 6 times, 7 times, 8 times. The point is that this building is older than most people in Christianity. And it was founded a long time ago. And Mount Moriah is special in that fact that it was ordained a long time before most of us were born. So there's a reason it's still here. There's a reason it's still open. There's a reason it's still going. But we thank God that we were able to merge with Harvest Army. And so we have support, we have brethren, you know, and we thank God for Dr. Katie Collins. And I believe Mount Moriah may be 30 or 40 years older than he is. So I'm just throwing that out there. Just give you a little number. It was here before he was born. But it now is a part of us, and he's a part of us, and we're a part of him, and God is a part of it all. See how God brings it all together? It's been a long time coming that Mount Moriah be put on the map. It's been mapped a long time ago, but the explosion and the foundation and the growth and getting the word out, the Lord witnessing, has to be worldwide because there's something special about the name of Jesus. There's something special about the name of Jesus. And what he started out here at the Hub, Hamlet, North Carolina, he's going to continue in the Hub in Atlanta, Georgia, and he's going to continue in Florida in the World Revival City, and he's going to continue in the Bronx, New York, and he's going to continue in Jamaica, and he's going to continue worldwide globally until the trumpet sounds and until he comes back. So we just want to send greetings from North Carolina to Harvest Army, all the leaders, and all Christians worldwide. We love you. Keep laboring for the Lord. Let's take a look at Revelation 5:7.
Brooklyn.
Whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting
Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, Jesus Christ.
And say, Jesus, and repent of their sin. Return to Jesus Christ, the sacrifice, whose life for you and me. Oh, God, to Jesus, repent. Turn away from your ways.
By the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel of Jesus Christ and the confession of John's faith and acceptance of Jesus Christ, I hereby baptize him in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. In Jesus' name, amen.
Okay, so we're going to stop it right there. We give the Lord a praise for what he's doing. Saving souls, preaching the gospel, baptizing people in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Ghost as he commands in Jesus' name. People are getting saved. Lives are getting changed. People are being healed. People are coming back to God. And that's what it's all about. Amen. That's why we do what we do. We don't do to condemn, to say we're better than anybody. We do it to say, hey, what God did for me, he could do for you too. Amen. That's what it's all about. That's what it's all about. That soft-spoken word a lot of times will pull a lot of people in. And they'll listen rather than you beating them over the head. Now, there is a time for that. There's a time for that where that hard heart has to have a hammer. And I was one of those that had to have that hammer. But sometimes I like to hear that soft word too. Most of the time, I love that hammer. Praise God. Let's worship the Lord this morning in spirit and in truth. Not just in truth and Bible. Let's worship him in spirit. Amen.
Give me that old-time religion. Give me that old-time religion. Give me that old-time religion. It's good enough for me. It was good for mothers. It was good for mothers. It was good for mothers. It's good enough for me. Give me that old-time religion. Give me that old-time religion. Give me that old-time religion. It's good enough for me. Makes me love everybody, makes me love everybody, makes me love everybody, it's good enough for me. Give me that old-time religion, give me that old-time religion, give me that old-time religion, it's good enough for me.
Hallelujah. Praise God, old ways, find the old path.
Pass me not, O gentle Savior, keep
There's another copyright strike on another books. In the name of Jesus, every video we do, every service we do, copyright strike. We pay them and they still copyright strike. My God in heaven. I thought if you got a subscription, you pay the money, you pay for copyrights. Now you got to pay copyright laws too. Oh, Jesus, you're never going to make ends meet around here. Let me tell you something. God's greater than everything. God's greater than the beast system. God's greater than copyright. God's greater than the world. God's greater than man. God's greater than all of, what is it called, the galaxy. He created it all. Praise God. It all belongs to him. The Bible says the earth is his and the fullness thereof. The world is his and the fullness thereof. That means copyrights and songs that are written to him too, that belong to God. Amen. We're going to get into the teaching this morning. I'm not certain because he had been having some troubles. I won't get into it, but he'd been having some troubles recently. Hope all is well. I know Brother Ted's at work and Mama's visiting another church and there's a couple other out sick. But we're going to get in. The first scripture I'm going to reach this morning is Isaiah 65:22. Then we're going to be in Matthew 7. We're going to teach a little bit about answered prayers, how to get God to answer your prayers. Some people might say, I just got to pray. Some people might say, well, you got to trust and believe. Some people might say, well, if you call on the name of Jesus. But let me ask you this. If I trust, believe, have faith, born again, and I call on the name of Jesus for me, will it be here in 1 second? Think about that. You got to be in line. You can ask him this. It says, and it shall come to pass, it shall come to pass, that before they call, before you even call, it's already about to be answered. I will answer, and while they are yet speaking, I will hear. The Bible says that the Lord has, he knows what you have need of before you even ask, or before you even think of it. Before you're even born, you're conformed in the image of God, and he conforms you in the belly of your mama. He knew you before birth, he tells Jeremiah. Now, Jeremiah was made a prophet. We're not all made prophets to the world. We were, but not all are prophets. Not all are apostles. Not all speak in tongues. Not all have interpretation of tongues. But the point is that we all are known by God before we're formed. And he knows every hair on our head. That's everybody. That's all. A-L-L. And before we ask and have need of the ministry, to keep the doors open, to keep the building function, to keep the lights on, to keep the internet going, amen, to keep water here, to keep, you know, all the supplements, before we even ask, he already knows what we have need of. So when we ask, he says right here, he says, and it shall come to pass. It's not a maybe, it's not a might. It's not a would, could, or should. It shall come to pass that before they call who? The name of Jesus. I will answer. He's going to answer our prayer requests. The Bible says, make your requests known unto God. And while they are yet speaking to who? To God. I will hear. He's going to give you his ear. Watch this now. The Bible also says, he that have an ear, let them hear what the Spirit says to the churches. And that's talking about the churches of God that he has ordained. It's not talking about somebody over around the corner in the woods somewhere trying to do something. He's talking about you got to hear him and he will hear you back. You reap what you sow. So let's go into Matthew chapter 7, verses 7 and 7, and then we'll be going to Matthew 18, and then we'll go to Matthew 21. Praise God. Answer prayers. Shagarabababashata. I'm uncertain why. I'm uncertain why people no longer use Sunday as a day of rest. I'm uncertain why Spectrum uses that day to always do tests and tries to start working with wires, but I have the power to pray in the name of Jesus to fix the situation. Whatever's going on every Sunday, it's stopped in Jesus' name. It really is. Matthew 18:19-20. Again, I say unto you that any two shall agree. How can two walk together except they be agreed? Book of Amos. On earth as touching anything that they shall ask, and it shall be done for them of my Father which is in heaven. In the Father's name, in Abba's name, in the Father God, Jehovah God, in the name of Jesus that gets to him. Jesus is the mediator. Praise the Father. If we agree touching anything that the Lord pour out his spirit, that somebody be healed, that somebody give their heart and life to Jesus, that the needs be met for the church, that people pay tithes and offerings faithfully, not every once in a while, that God would convict their hearts. In Jesus' name, it shall be done. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst. That word midst means the middle, right in the very middle or center. On the cross, the heart of God was in the very center of the left hand and right hand. It was in the midst. He's in the midst. He's in the middle of people. He's not left. He's not all the way right. He's right with God, but not directional. Left or right is straight down the middle in the midst. Amen. That means that he wasn't the darkest person on planet Earth. He wasn't the lightest person on planet Earth. He was in the midst. That means that he's not for this person or for that person. He's for God in the midst. That means, hallelujah, everything. He's in the midst of us. He's in the middle. Blessed are the peacemakers, if you will. Now let's go to Matthew 18 and 19. Let's go to Matthew 21 and 22. Let's see what it says, and then we're going to go to Mark 11. And then we're going to touch in John. In the category of answered prayer, somebody might be saying, or somebody is saying, I'm sorry, why hasn't God answered my prayer? Think about this. When God doesn't answer, that is an answer. Sometimes we ask something and we ask it amiss. We miss the mark of in the midst. We miss the mark of the name of Jesus or why God would do something and be glorified for it. Would God be glorified or would we be glorified? You have to consider those factors. And answered prayers are for the glory of God and the kingdom of God and the growth of the kingdom of God. So if God is not growing his kingdom, then what is he doing? If he's not adding addition to the church, if finances haven't been met, if souls are not being won, if lives are not being saved, if deliverance is not happening, praise God, if people are not coming to Jesus, then what's really happening? So in a nutshell, when we get a van, we're going to get people. That's why he answered that prayer. When the doors are opened, there's going to be a revival. That's why he keeps the doors open. When we get the internet, it goes out worldwide. That's why we have that. So each provision, each prayer, each revelation is for the glory of the kingdom of God and growth. So you might be saying, why is all this happening for them? And why is all that happening for them? A1 sauce is humble. Be humble. Two is prayer. pray by faith and trust and believe when you pray, it will happen. And three, most importantly, plead the blood against hindrance. Did you hear what I said? Plead the blood against hindrance. Do you remember Daniel? And Daniel was praying. He was a mighty man of God. He was a man of faith. You know, he was a righteous man, upstanding, upright with God. And he would pray, and the prince of the power to err, would hinder the prayer. And the angel came and said, pray again. Sometimes it takes two or three prayers. Then you get an answer and response. Rebuke the devil, plead the blood. Use the name of Jesus. All power and authority is given. And then you might see a difference. Praise God. Where did I say we're going? 21 to 22. And all things whatsoever ye shall ask in prayer, believing, you shall receive. Believe and then receive. Believe on who? Jesus. By faith in what? The cross. Mount Calvary. The bloodshed. When I see the blood, I will pass over you. I will bless you. Praise God. Now let's go in Mark 11:24. Somebody might say Matthew's account slightly different than Mark's. Well, aren't my accounts slightly different than yours? Not drastically. They're still one accord. They're still all things common, or they should be. They should be. You know, they shouldn't be so far, you know, from the east to west that Jesus has to come in the midst and clean it all up. But he will, if he has to. Mark 11:24, therefore I say unto you, what things soever ye desire, when ye pray, believe, and ye receive them, and ye shall have them. It's that simple. Somebody might say, I want $1 million. Well, why do you want $1 million? You want $1 million for self or Jesus? Do you want $1 million so you can go win souls, or do you want $1 million just because you want $1 million? If you want $1 million to win souls, that's possibility. That's within the realm of possibility. But if you want $1 million, the love of money is the root to all evil. The love. Money is not the root to all evil. The love of it is the root to all evil. Now we're going to go to John 14, John 15, and John 16. We're going to stay there a few moments. Amen. In the teaching this morning, prayers are key to ministry, Christianity, and faith. Prayers are keys to unlock doors that Jesus stands at to bless. John 14:13, I'm sorry. Similar. So that God be glorified when he answers the prayer, the door swings wide open, and you know, without a shadow of a doubt, it was him. It was a man out doing a bunch of whatever man do. And whatsoever ye shall ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. You see there, when Jesus prays to the Father, and the Father sends the Comforter, and the Comforter busts down walls of Jericho and opens up new doors and sends keys for the kingdom's sake, Jesus and the Father are glorified together. Can you separate me and my household? Can you separate me from my children? Really? Can you separate that DNA in there and find mine from theirs? You cannot separate God the Father and the Son either. They are one and the same, and they will be glorified together. Not one in the other or one in the other, but together in unison. Praise God. Whenever my children rejoice, I rejoice. Whenever I rejoice, my children rejoice. Now, John 15 and 7, and then John 16 and 23. John 15 and 7 says, if ye abide in me and my words abide in you, Ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. On your behalf, through the Spirit, pray, making intercession for you. You can ask, Lord Jesus, fill my cup up. Lord Jesus, I need more spiritual strength. Lord Jesus, I need strength to go on. I need a healing to take place. I need a miracle in Jesus' name, and it shall be done. I need healing in my body. I need provisions for my household. I need food for my family. Lord, you know what we have need of, and I'm not asking that you glorify me. I'm asking that you glorify thyself. Lord, send the ravens in Jesus' name. Send the manna from heaven, and it shall be. It shall be. John 16:23, in that day ye shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whatsoever ye shall ask the Father in my name, he will give it to you. God will hold back no great gifts from his children and his people. They will be blessed going in, and they will be blessed coming out of Mount Moriah. They will be blessed going into God's presence. They will be blessed coming out. They will be blessed going into God's word. They will be blessed coming out. Praise the Lord. Hebrews 4:16, and then we're going to go into Psalms and Proverbs, and we'll be closing Sunday school this morning. Show me the way, one day at a time. Hebrews, Jewish book, yet still for Gentiles we can read to see how far the apostles have written to the Israelites, Israel. Let us therefore come boldly unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of need. If you are needful, if you need things, take it to the Lord in prayer. Go to your prayer closet. Come to the altar of God. Go to the altar of your heart. Pray in the Spirit. Pray boldly. Now watch this now. In the word bold, there's a word there in the midst, in the middle. Can you see it? Old. Old, bold, bold, old. Find the old pathways and walk therein. Book of Jeremiah, right? So it's the old time religion that gets it done. Come on, somebody. It's not a new path. It's not a new way. It's not the new age. It's the bold and the old and the old and the bold that gets it done. The way that has established and rooted and grounded. Now, take a look at grace. There's a word in there, the last three letters. What do you got?
Ace.
Ace. So you got an ace in the hole. You got the King of Hearts being Jesus Christ, and he's always got an ace up his sleeve. And the way to ace, the ace that he has, is the grace. And we obtain mercy and grace. Can you get more grace and mercy? Or do you just get one grace and mercy? More and more? Oh, I didn't know that. So there's an ace every time, huh? In the grace. There's more aces. There's more graces. In the good graces of God, there's a way. It seemeth right unto a man, but the end thereof are the ways of death. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There were times that we prayed for people out here and they were healed and they never came back. And there were times that we prophesied to people out here and they never came back. And I have to oftentimes pray about those things because I say, Lord, you know, I know people don't understand everything. And I know people don't understand that gift and power and authority. And the Lord tells me oftentimes is they don't like their life displayed. The Lord's not trying to embarrass anybody. He's telling you that you have the power and authority over what you're going through. That's the prophecy. There's more grace for you. There's more mercy for you. That's the prophecy. He's not trying to tell you and embarrass you that, praise God, that, you know, you're gonna die. He's not going to tell you that. He's going to tell you you're going to live, and he's going to tell you you're blessed and you're healed in Jesus' name. Those are the things he tells us. Well, when people hear that, they say, what kind of church is this? Where am I? What did I get myself into? I come out here, I just want to have some normal routine religion. Well, that ain't out here. And that's why you're up the road now. Because it's not normal what God does out here. It's supernatural. The ability to tell you how to change your life and get deliverance. Not to condemn. Not to judge. Not to put down. Not to tell people that we're better than anybody. But to tell you how to walk in victory in Jesus' name. Plead the blood, bind and loose just like we can. That's it. It's in the Bible. You pray, you ask, you receive, you believe, you achieve. It's that simple. So when people get singled out, they don't like that. They don't understand that. But didn't God single you out when he saved your soul? Amen. Didn't God single you out when he blessed you? Amen. Didn't God single you out, hallelujah, when he healed you? Amen. Well, it's no different. It's no different. He wants to bless you some more with some more grace and give you some more faith. Hallelujah. Let's go to Psalm 37 and 4, and then we're going to Psalm 91. I might read all of it, but I'm going to let the Lord lead me. Praise God. Psalm 37, and that number, let's look at this real quick. I don't want to go that far with it. But let's look at 3 and 7. You got 3, 37. You got name of the Son and Holy Ghost, 3 and 7, right? And you got 7, number of completion. The sixth day he created man, the seventh day he rested. It makes no, never mind. If he started on Sunday or he started on Saturday or he started on Monday, it still was 6 days. And then he rested. Pick one. Amen. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and he shall give thee the desires of thine heart. Now, if you have desires, if your heart wants something, if you long for something, and it's a good thing, you can very well ask the Lord, Lord, I want to receive the gift of learning how to play the piano. Lord, I want the preaching spirit of boldness to come upon me and anoint me. And it will very well happen. Lord, I want to learn how to teach better. The desire of your heart. What is something you've asked God for and he's answered? You don't have to tell me, but just reflect of where he's brought you from. Just reflect on how many prayers he has answered. You say you're praying for the one thing and you never get it, but how many other prayers have you prayed and you've got it? I want you to reflect back, because sometimes we forget where we come from. We forget our own personal land of Egypt that he brought us from. Jesus, I want to share something with you. So many prayers that God answered for me, and powerful and boldly, miracles. I'm going to share two. There was a certain lady that God gave me the name of one time. I won't call her name. She's gone on to be with the Lord now. And the Lord gave me her name and face, and I began to pray. And I didn't know what I was praying for. I was praying in the spirit. And as I began to pray, I just did what he told me to. I never knew for some time until she was on a sickly bed, ready to be called home to be with the Lord. And I went and prayed with her. You know, she was on the phone. She called me on the phone. I'm sorry. That was another time she told me another story when I went to visit. She called me and told me that one time she had bologna, she had cheese, and she had ketchup, and she had all the condiments that you could think of. She had, you know, mayonnaise, mayo, she had mustard. But she didn't have any bread. And she got to asking God to send her bread and have somebody pray for her. Watch this now. Well, that somebody was me that prayed for her. She said that all of a sudden, she looked outside. God said, look outside. And she seen all these little packages and little plastic wrappers all up and down her driveway. Her driveway is like this. Long dirt. Don't ever go down there. You might get stuck. Because I did one or two, once or twice. She goes outside. She says, I can't believe it. There was all amounts of bread that you could ask for. Every kind. All up and down her driveway right in front of her house. Nowhere else. She looked down the road. So apparently some Merita truck or some kind of bread truck forgot to shut the door, and it started hitting them bumps, and it started shaking out the bread, and the bread started falling, and she went out there and she got every bit of it. She gave it to her neighbors and her friends and her relatives, and she kept some for herself too. Now that was a miracle that God had did, just like the ravens. And I'll never forget it, because that's how God is. Abundantly. Not just one slice of bread. Not just one batch of bread. So much you can't even count. It's loaves upon loaves. And then this one's going to be difficult. You got to pray for me. There was a time that our daughter was born. Some 8 years ago, and her middle name is Grace for a certain reason. Jesus had an ace that day. She's still got a little birthmark right here. And when she came out, she was as blue as the sky, sky blue, her face. No cry, nothing. And they said that the umbilical cord was wrapped around her throat. And they called all the dog specialists. They started making phone calls. Sister Jessica said, is everything okay? I didn't answer. There's a corner over there in the room. In the hospital room, and I faced that wall, and I faced the corner. I said, Lord, I don't believe this, and I don't receive it. I don't believe that you did this. I would not accept this. Lord, I pray in the name of Jesus that I pray in the name of Jesus that you turn this situation around. And it wasn't 2 seconds before I finished. And I said, in the name of Jesus. I heard my daughter cry, the first cry she's ever cried. And then I went back to Sister Jessica. I said, yes, everything is okay. They gave Jesmyn Grace Williams to Jessica Lynn Williams. And she held the baby and she cried, cut the umbilical cord. And they said, she's always going to have that mark. And he said, to remember what I have done. He's got an ace in the grace. I'm telling you, we serve a mighty God. We serve a mighty God. People are foolish to say they're still not apostles and prophets. Prophecies, dreams, visions. They're foolish to say he don't work in miracles and heal. They're just foolish to not understand how he is. My God, in Hebrews 3:1, it says he's the apostle of our faith. If there's no more left, he's the one. We got about 5 minutes, and I'm going to read real quickly. You can write them down if you would like. I'll try to take it slow. Psalm 91:15. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and honor him. Psalm 145:18-19. The Lord is nigh unto all them that call upon him, to all that call upon him in truth. He will fulfill the desires of them that fear him. He also will hear their cry and will save them. Proverbs 15:29. Proverbs 15:29. This is how to have your prayers answered quickly. How to have your prayers answered more so. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Come on in, ladies. Come on in. Welcome. Welcome. Good to see y'all. Hallelujah. Proverbs 15:19. The Lord is far from the wicked, but he heareth the prayer of the righteous. Jeremiah 33:3. It says, call unto me. Call unto who? Jesus. And I will answer thee. He's making a promise to his believers. He will answer you and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. So he's going to tell you things that you don't know. He's going to show you things you don't expect. He's going to show you things and tell you things not always in the text. It was not in the text that Jesmyn Grace Williams shall be spared. It wasn't in the text, but it happened, and it was Jesus. Matthew said, but thou, when thou prayest, enter into thy closet, and when thou hast shut thy door, pray to thy Father, which is in secret, and thy Father, which seeth in secret, shall reward thee openly. How many has ever prayed in secret, and God rewarded you, blessed you openly? It says, do not pray as the hypocrites do on the street corner, nor in that they pray long prayers that they want to be heard and seen of men, but pray to your Father which art in heaven. It's okay to pray aloud. It's okay to pray in open. It's okay to pray on the street corner and in the church, but to be heard and seen is another story. Pray to the Father who art in heaven. If nobody ever prayed, if nobody ever heard anybody pray, how would people learn to pray that don't know how to pray? Hello, somebody. Last verse. 1 John 3:22. And whatsoever we ask, we receive of him, because we keep his commandments and do those things that are pleasing in his sight. In his sight. He's always watching. He's always waiting. He's always listening for the prayer of his saints. Amen. God has an ace in grace. G-R-A-C-E, Ace and Grace, in Jesus' name. Anybody have anything they want to say regarding to the teaching and lesson this morning?
You forgot.
Now you know what you could do right there, and that I'm glad that this happened. I'm sorry it happened to you, but I'm glad that it's on the spot. It happens to us often. When we're going to glorify God, here comes the devil and he steals it. You could say, Satan, I rebuke you in Jesus' name, and I plead the blood. Lord, send it back by way of the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. It's happened to me countless times. I've been up here preaching, and I was going to say something real good, and whoosh, yeah, the lying devil came, but I prayed, and before the service was over, it came out. It's real. It's good to see my aunt this morning, not an aunt on the ground, aunt. It's good to see mama. My sister, what a surprise. Also, it's good to see Church Mother Diane. Again, we know there's many out and sick, and there's many other fear and fear. I rebuke that fear in the name of Jesus. I rebuke the fear in the name of Jesus, because the Bible says no weapon formed against us shall prosper. The Bible tells us, praise God, the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church. We have to realize that's coming on the planet, that's fear coming on the planet, and we can't receive it or believe it. It's Satan's agenda for us to fear, but perfect love casts out all fear. Come on, somebody. The power of God and the presence of God and the favor of God and the love of God and the Spirit of God is greater than all.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Anything else? Anybody else in the teaching this morning? I'm going to ask, Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we dismiss Sunday school. We thank you for the privilege to preach and teach your word, to read and study your word. Father, lead us for the remainder of service. Bless us indeed for the power of the Holy Ghost. I thank you for your people. I thank you for your favor. I thank you, hear us. I thank you for hearing this when we pray. Lord, fill our spirits, clear our hearts and minds, make us whole and new, afresh. Give us your strength and power to do your work on planet Earth. For it's in Jesus' name I humbly pray. Amen and amen and amen. Praise God. You're going to read a scripture. Receive this morning our children's ministry.
Clouds are wonderful. The Lord went ahead of them. He guided them during the day with a pillar of cloud. If the weather is good, the clouds look soft and fluffy. They look so nice to jump on, almost like jumping on a castle. Have you ever watched the clouds? Some clouds look like a ship, or like a dog or a duck. It is great to watch new shapes all the time. Clouds are wonderful things. They bring rain for plants to grow. They provide water for humans and animals without clouds. We can't swim or bathe. We can't cook or even boil a kettle. When a storm is coming, clouds look angry, but then make a lot of noise. Lightning flashes. Before long, all clouds disappear, just like opening a curtain to let the sun in. God makes every cloud, from the tiniest white cloud to the biggest, darkest thundercloud. He made a special cloud for the Israelites when they traveled through the desert. God said, follow this cloud, I will show you where to go. Something to think about. God makes every single cloud wonderful. Imagine you are floating on a cloud over your house. What do you see? Prayer. Dear Jesus, thank you for making clouds that bring rain. Amen.
Amen.
The stars are like sheep. God made stars and the moon like a big shepherd. Stars, sheep, moon, shepherd.
Amen in Jesus' name. Yeah, I didn't notice that.
Praise the Lord again.
You can't forget. Thank you. Yes, Lord.
Yes, Jesus. Thank you, Father. Hallelujah.
Cross where thou hast died, draw me near, near, oh blessed Lord, to thy precious bleeding side. Amen. Praise the Lord. We're going to take up offering. Mother, will you play something on the piano slow and soft and supple? Praise God. Come by faith, if you would. If you would like to sow into the ministry in the church this morning, God bless you abundantly. Praise God. His service, his building, his servant, his ministry, is his power and presence. Feet. Amen. All the things we have in common. That means if I speak in tongues, you speak in tongues. You didn't hear what I said. That means if you got $1,000, I got $1,000. We got all things in common. If you got a log cabin at the mountains, I got a log cabin at the mountains. You didn't hear what I said. Praise God. If you have your Bibles, will you please turn with me to Luke, the 10th chapter, verses 19 through 21, three scriptures, kind of like bulk scriptures, paragraph, if you will, and notice the bulk of it is written in red letters of Jesus, that means the blood of Jesus. Luke, the 10th chapter, verses 19 through 21. It says, Christ sendeth out 70 disciples and woes against Chorazin and Bethsaida and Capernaum, very commended, etc. If you're there, will you please stand for the reading of God's holy word? Luke, the 10th chapter, verses 19 through 21. Thank you for being here. Thank the Spirit of God for being here. Thank God for the reading of his word. It says, Behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions, and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall be any means hurt you. Notwithstanding, in this rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. In that hour Jesus rejoiced in spirit and said, I thank thee, O Father, Lord of heaven and earth, that thou hast hid these things from the wise and the prudent, and hast revealed them unto babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good in thy sight. It seemed good in thy sight. You may be seated. Most gracious and merciful Heavenly Father, Lord, I come humbly before you, asking you to anoint your servant one more time. Anoint these lips of clay that I might seem to apprehend the power and spirit of the Almighty God, not just in truth and letter and wisdom, but also in spirit, anointing and power. Lord, I thank you that you have called us, you have anointed us, you have saved us, you have redeemed us for such a time as this. that we have power over the enemy, over the adversary, to tread on serpents and scorpions in this very hour, right now present. We can tread upon serpents and scorpions, that it shall not come nigh us, Lord. Once again, anoint my lips of clay. Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, my Lord, my God, my strength, my power, my all in all, my rock, my redeemer, in Jesus' name. And we all say together, amen and amen. It says, behold, I give unto you, give unto who? His people. Power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. That means that there's no power that Satan has that's more powerful than God and the Spirit of God has given you. All the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. Notwithstanding in this, rejoice not that the spirits are subject unto you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in heaven. That's worth rejoicing. We're going to heaven. That hour, Jesus rejoiced in spirit and said, I thank thee, O Father, my Lord of heaven and earth, that thou hast hid these things from the wise and the prudent and hast revealed them unto babes. Even so, Father, for so it seemed good in thy sight, he has given it to us. Whatever God has seen good in his sight, he gives it to his children. The power of the Holy Ghost, the power in the name of Jesus, the power in the blood of Jesus, the power to overcome, the power of the Spirit of God, the strength of God, the favor of God, the blessings of God, the callings of God are without repentance, and I thank God. The gifts and anointings of God are without repentance. The power of the Holy Ghost is ever available to those that call on his name. He will answer and give all power and all authority. Not some power, not some authority, but all. Somebody say all.
All.
Amen. Before we start, there's a scripture that's in the text, by their fruits you will know them. Does anybody know it? How can you tell if you are dealing with people or serpents or evil spirits of God? Are you ready for this? The title of this message, by the way, is Stomp. Stomp. Number one, check it. People thrive on emotions. That's when you're dealing with people. Come on, son. People thrive on emotions. Serpents stay hidden until you don't know, want to know when the until is, when they're at your ankle, and then you're going to stomp on them. Am I right? Amen. Evil spirits are exposed by only the Holy Spirit. Amen. Oh, somebody. And God is strictly love. Thank God for Jesus. Is there a fruit of excuse? I say not. Is there the fruit of the spiritual disobedience? Absolutely not. Is there a fruit of rebellion or slothfulness or enablement? There isn't. Hallelujah. What is it then? I thought I was saved by the Holy Spirit and, praise God, sanctified by the Holy Ghost. What's happening? No rejoicing. Watch me now. Only pain, only sorrow, no power, no authority, no victory. But God has given us all power, authority, and victory. So what is happening? Only pain, only sorrow, no power, authority, no victory. Rest assured, if you are not delivered and walk not in victory, you cannot encourage others to walk in victory and preach true, full blast deliverance in the slightest, let alone completely. Think about it. Watch me now. We have a calling and an obligation to God to stomp on the enemy's head. To stomp on the devil's head. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. There was a snake story I want to share with you. An old country bumpkin, kind of like myself, driving an old pickup truck, kind of like myself. I got a slightly new pickup truck, but you get the point. Praise God. I thank God for the slightly new pickup truck. I used to drive an old one. But he was driving down the road. And on the side of the road, he sees an old snake. And it was in bad shape, man, I tell you. It needed some food. Well, he picked that bad boy up and he put it in his truck. Watch me now. And he began to feed it. He was riding along the road, right? He sees the snake. He picks the snake up. He puts it in the truck. He begins to talk with it. He begins to feed it. He begins to give it water and nutrients. All of a sudden, he started hearing a rattle. Now, snake, don't you bite me. Don't you bite me. He kept feeding it, and talking to it. All of a sudden, it got him. He said, "Why'd you do that?" The snake replied, "So oftentimes Christianity deals with snakes and serpents. Instead of treading on their heads, they pick them up and they dance with them and they love them and they kiss them and they feed them and they nurture them, knowing they're snakes. Come on, somebody. You better throw that snake away in Jesus' name. Glory to God. You better trample on that snake in Jesus' name. God has given you power and authority, not just some, but all power and authority has been given to you. To stomp on their heads." Glory to God. Mark chapter 16. Let's go there. Mark chapter 16, verses 15 through 20. Hallelujah. I don't want to lose you. Did I lose you? Mark chapter 6. You dare say amen. I could quote it, but I just want to, I want you to see it. It says, "And he said unto them, Go ye into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature." That includes serpents. Tell somebody. "And he that believeth is baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not shall be damned. And these signs shall follow them that believe in my name. They shall cast out devils. They shall speak with new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. After the Lord had spoken unto them, he was received up into heaven and sat at the right hand of God. And they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them, and confirming the word with signs following." Amen. You have that power today. You have that authority today. Hallelujah. The Lord is saying right now, in the spirit, you might not believe who you are in him, but listen to me now, what the God says to you. Believe who he is in you. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. You might not believe in who you are in God, but believe who he is and what his word says. Hallelujah. The great job known to man is to win souls. He that wins souls is wise. Preaching is universal to every creature. We are on a mission of hope, a mission of love, a mission of grace and mercy. There are promises to believers, and unbelievers are condemned by their own selves by not believing in the word. It tells you right there, signs are given in Jesus' name. And that name, there is power. There is power in the name of Jesus. There's authority in the name of Jesus to cast out devils, to lay hands on the sick. If you lay hands on the sick in Jesus' name by the blood, they will recover. Somebody might say, "By his stripes, we are healed." Glory to God. That's one scripture. But the KJV says, "With his stripes." That means Jesus working with you and you working with Jesus. Come on, somebody. Amen. You have power and authority. If you just believe, you can achieve. You will receive the power today. A new calling, a new mantle, a new anointing, a new in Jesus' mighty name. You got to believe in what is written, what the scripture says. Thus saith the Lord to the
the people of God. Hallelujah. Signs are given in Jesus' name, and that power is named to cast out devils, the gifts of healing. Christ is exalted and glorified and magnified. God's word is true, and it must be preached and proclaimed boldly with a zeal of love and passion. Come on, somebody, stop on the devil's heel. Take your foot like that and just start to do it. Stomp on the devil's head. Yeah. Stomp on the devil's head. Amen. Anytime that the devil comes lying to you, remember you have that calling. You have that mantle. You have that authority. You have that anointing to call on the name of Jesus and stomp on the devil's head. Hallelujah. God's word and God alone. I'm going to go back real quick. I got ahead of myself. I skipped over one note. I don't want to leave out one jot or tittle. One must cooperate with other believers and with God. One must cooperate with other believers and with God. The Bible says one put 3,000 to flight and two put 10,000 to flight. Now, how many are put to flight today in this very building? If one put 3,000 enemies and serpents on the run, if we all get on the war path, how many thousands and how many legions would have to go in the name of Jesus? Think about it. Think about it. Glory to God. If we enable anything, it needs to be more grace in this time. It doesn't need to be enablement of people, how we raise people, how we treat people, how we talk to people. It needs to be more grace in Jesus' name, more devil stomping. Glory to God, more power. We promises when we are tempted, there will be a way of escape. Come on, somebody. Think about it. How many times have you ever been tempted? I've been tempted. I know all about temptation. Temptation does not come from God. Comes from the serpents. But you can stomp on their head and Jesus will make a way out. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Satan is limited and there is a secure satisfaction in Jesus' name. Scripture says the eyes of man are never satisfied, but Paul the apostle said he was content in what he had been given of God. Do you suppose a man can get content, or is that the Lord's work where our finally says, I'm truly satisfied right now in the spirit I'm in the calling I have on my life, I'm truly satisfied in Jesus. It's God, right? It's not man. Because if Paul was still in his flesh, he would still be unsatisfied. But because we serve Jesus, we have total supreme satisfaction. Hallelujah. Is that a word? Satisfaction. Satisfaction guaranteed. There you go. Thank you for helping me out. That's not a word. God in heaven. See, even preachers need help. So Satan is limited and we have secure satisfaction. Hallelujah. Okay, let's go on to the next scripture and the next notes. We have a heavenly home, a citizenship of heaven, not of this world. Our names are in the Lamb's book of life. Well, hallelujah, somebody. I'm on my way to heaven. I'm heaven bound. This is revelation, and it's ever given to the simple minded. Think about that thing. God has given to the simple minds of children and babes to understand there is a heaven, there is a God, and we all can go there, and we all have a power and authority given from heaven in Jesus' name. I want y'all to bear with me now. Remember what I tell you right now. Remember what I tell you. Fear not. The prayers of Christ are that you succeed. It is his joy and passion that we work for him and we work together and he works for us. Come on, somebody. Satan is under submission and subjection today, right now, in Jesus' name. The book stops here. Hallelujah. The book stops here, if you will. Matthew. say, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. I'm not certain why God keeps bringing me to the Great Commission and the Macedonia call, as well as the last days outpouring of world revival. Other than that's what the ministry I have been obtained is, and that's what his word and ministry is. But this is us, and we need to stomp the snakes into the dirt in Jesus' name, way down, down, down deep. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want to share with you a dream that my daughter had. One time, she doesn't know what she dreams now. I want you to know she didn't call a name, she didn't call a person, but God gives dreams and visions of protection from snakes. Watch me now. She said there was a man that came into the building, and she didn't call his name. She said he came, and he came to help out at sin. But every time he came, he would lay down a snake, and he would lay down another snake. And he'd come into the building, and he'd lay down another snake. Now, I'm here to tell you something. We're not going to call no names. But Janus and Jamborees withstood Moses, so that these also withstand us these last days. Jason dreamed that dream of a man coming out of nowhere to come into the building to lay down serpents. But remember what the Lord says. In the last days there will be false prophets. There will be many come in his name, saying, I am of Christ. And deceive many. But you can't deceive God's elect. You can't deceive God's church. You can't deceive God's people. And God sent a dream and vision to tell us that we needed to pray for the church and pray for the people and pray for the church and pray for the people. And last week he gave a mighty revival in Jesus' name in this very building. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. Guess what? Serpents were driven out. Serpents were cast out. People were healed. People were saved. People came back to God. And Jesus gets the glory and power.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Stomp on the devil's head. Glory to God. Stomp on the devil's head. I got a couple more pages. Bear with me now. Jesus said, he will make you fishers of men. And in the fish mouth would be a help of taxes and tithes. A lot of people don't get that. He said, whose superscription is on this coin? They said, Caesar. He said, render to Caesar the things that belong to Caesar. Didn't stop right there. He said, also render unto God the things that belong to God. That means tithing. Hello? Both man's government and God's government are taken care of by the Lord. You don't believe me? He says it rains on the just and the unjust. He said, I'm not going to get ahead of myself. Many tithes, dollars that we've dodged. And how is your spirituality? How is our health? Because I give you fish and I give you meat, and we withhold. We don't withhold any good gift and a blessing. Today we stop that lying serpent into the ground. Hallelujah. Either increase is coming or Jesus is coming. Increase is coming to the house of God, or the Lord is on his way. He's coming back to take the obedient from the disobedient. Be not deceived. Stomp on the devil's head. Their portion shall be as the hypocrites with the unbelievers. It says, I break it in Jesus' name. I bind it, I loose it, and cast it out. And amen. There are so many ways to sow. There is no excuse in person, by mail, cash out, PayPal, Venmo, text to give, Square. Hallelujah. We have exhausted resources because of excuses. Today it's time to stomp the snakes of all kind. We got to stomp on the devil's head. We got to stomp lazy snakes. We got to stomp excuse snakes. We got to stomp with disobedient snakes. gotta stop rebellious snakes. We gotta stop confusing snakes. We gotta stop enabling snakes. We gotta stop religious snakes. We gotta stop lying snakes. We gotta stop hindering snakes. We gotta stop venomous snakes. We gotta stop snakes. Snakes no more. It's time to stomp. Y'all ready to stomp? Matthew 7:10. Or if he asked for a fish, would he give him a serpent? If you ask God for a fish, would he give you a snake? What's he going to give you? A fish. And what's in the fish's mouth? A coin. And what are we supposed to do with the coin? Keep it to sell. Fear not. Again, I say fear not. Are you ready? Snake. What you going to do with it? You going to pick it up and take it in your chest? Stomp on the devil's head. Stomp on the devil's head. It may seem like a game, but it's not a game. It's reality. It's serious work that you are called, you are chosen, you are anointed for such a time as this. Perfect love casts out all fear. The Bible says Eve was the first to be deceived by the power of the serpent. You've not been bamboozled today. You have Christ. Come on, somebody. We must have pure hearts, pure minds, fully devoted to God. In Matthew 23:33, there is only power over religion, power over politic failure, political failure, over Sadducees and Pharisees teaching. Just as Moses lifted up the snake in the wilderness, Christ was also golden and lifted as a healer. We must be wise as serpents and harmless as doves. Come forward to stomp on the serpent, stomp on Satan. Hallelujah. Dip on the, dance on the devil's head, if you will. You have power to today. All power and victory is given to you right now if you declare and decree with me. Sing praise and worship. Hallelujah. Rejoice. You have the prize of heavenly citizenship in God's army. We are harvest army. This is the last day's harvest, and God is about to show up. Hallelujah. He's got an army raised up. You are a part of the army of the last day's church. We are the church triumphant. We had the victory today over serpents and scorpions and devils. I'm telling you, if you stomp on the devil's head, glory to God. If you submit yourself unto God, if you resist the devil, he's got to flee and go in Jesus' name. You have power and authority to cast out devils. Cast off devils away from you and your finances, hallelujah, and your body and your people and your family. Glory to God and your friendships, hallelujah. The devil has to go in the mighty matchless name of Jesus, in the maximum name of Jesus. Get out of here, you lying devil. Stomp on the devil's head. Glory to God. No more financial troubles, because we're going to pay tithes right. No more health troubles, because we're going to be obedient right. Hallelujah. No more spiritual troubles, because we're going to come and get fed in Jesus' name. That's the only way to stomp on the devil's head, is to do what the Bible tells you to do. We can't have victory if we don't gather. We can't have strength if we don't have revival. We can't receive financial blessings if we don't pay tithes. Hello, somebody. Does the Bible tell you that we ought to do it? The Bible also says, put your faith in Jesus, the blood, the Holy Ghost. I want everybody to form a line right here. I want you to form a line. And I want you to stomp on the devil's head today. And God's going to give you victory.